told me to my face that Sicko Mode was his biggest song. We're gone, cause Donna was the best ghost rider I ever had. South Park had jokes about fist sticks. To this day, the whole team could kiss this stick. I put Virgil and Drake on the same text, and it wasn't about the matching Arc'teryx or Kid Cudi dress. Just told these grown men, stop it with the funny shit. I might hire the whole team from ACG. So don't text me like I'm Juanita JCV. Or more important, Monica Corgan, who was there for me. Somebody really there for me was rare for me. That was new air to breathe. When I was underappreciated, undervaluated, stockholders told me boardrooms would bore you. Can't remember going by your rules. Try to follow the Lord's rules. Jawi was the new Abu Dhabi. Told Drake don't play with me on GD. And he sent that message to everybody.
Hey man, real Stay Say shit, you already know what the fuck is going on. So we tapped in today. I didn't put on my fucking glasses, man, cause this is a spectacle, no kizzy. So this nigga Drake just dropped the hardest song this year, I would say, and it's not his. This nigga Drake just dropped the fucking Kanye West featuring Andre 3000 track called Life of the Party, which basically disses Drake, where this nigga Kanye basically goes off on Drake. Like, this nigga Kanye sort of just, I don't know, like, this nigga's song was, like, honestly, I feel like the hardest song that was on, it wasn't on either of those two projects, but out of the whole fucking, between Certified Lover Boy and Donda, this is, like, the hardest track that I've heard. Maybe even the hardest track of this year, man. This man sort of just went on a whole rampage on Drake, and he basically just went off of him. And it's been a beef that's been going on for a long time. Kanye was saying that this nigga Drake basically fucked like every single other member of the Kardashians on some petty shit just cuz. And it's just like a wild situation. Like, this nigga Kanye is really saying that Drake is really just like petty and under his skin at all times. But in this verse, this man Kanye, he claims GD, yo, and it's like, this is what he says verbatim. He says, I put Virgil and Drake on the same text, and it wasn't about the matching Archer text or Kid Cudi dress. Just told these grown men, stop it with the funny shit. I might hire the whole team at ACG, so don't text me like I'm Juanita JCB, or more important, Monica Corgan, who was there for me. Somebody really there for me was rare for me. That was the air to breathe. When I was underappreciated, undervalued, stockholders told me boardrooms would bore you. And remember by your rules, try to follow the Lord's rules. Thought we was the new Abu Dhabi. Told Drake, don't play with me on GD. And he sent that message to everybody. So if I hit you with what are you doing, WID, you better hit me with a yes sir, I'm writing everything you need. So this nigga basically just, I don't know, like, that shit, that song was all bars, bro. This nigga came out of nowhere with this shit. Why this wasn't on the Donda fucking album, I don't know. Why Drake leaked this shit, I have no idea, because this song is harder than personally anything that was on Certified Lover Boy. This song is fire, and it has Andre 3000, who I haven't even heard on a song in damn near fucking 10 years, nigga. Like, that shit crazy. I feel like the craziest thing about this song is this nigga Kanye claiming GD, and I don't know what, like, this, isn't this nigga supposed to be a pastor? Like, I know that there's, like, regular people, but it's like, this nigga just, I thought this nigga was a pastor. This is a new fucking, this nigga Kanye, like, a damn onion, nigga. Like, he's like an onion, nigga. Like, he has different fucking, like, layers that you gotta peel by, and then randomly you'll see him claiming GD and shit. And then it's like, why the fuck? Like, this was on Drake's radio show that he leaked this shit, his Apple radio show. So it's like, why in the fuck would this nigga leak this shit? And everyone was like, yo, he's playing chess. It's like, nah, that song is gas, nigga. Like, I don't know, bro. Like, Certified Lover Boy is fire. Donda was fire. Personally, I felt like Donda was more experimental, and Certified Lover Boy was like a dope ass like Drake album, but I felt like it wasn't doing anything new. So it's was like the fact that this nigga Kanye released, or Drake released this Kanye diss track. I don't know what the fuck he was going with there. Like, that track is hard as fuck. Like, the vibes of it is hard as fuck. Like, this nigga, like, I don't know. Like, Kanye was almost out of his fucking pastor, preacher, deacon element. No cap. Like, I don't know. This nigga fucking Deacon West, claiming GD pastor, man. This shit a whole nother level of craziness. Like, who the fuck would have expected it even got to this point? I wonder if they're just, like, plotting together at this point. But it seems like they're about to start dissing. I mean, I don't know. There are people who have been saying they've been cool now, but it's like, I don't know how they could be cool when they be dissing each other and sub-dissing. I know Drake was in Certified Lover Boy, was dissing, sub-dissing a lot of people. He dissed Swiss Beats, he was dissing Kanye and shit. Like, man, it's only time's gonna tell how the fuck this is gonna go. Maybe Jake's gonna release another track, but it's like, you already dropped his album. He broke the record for the most streams in a day this year. So it's like, I don't know what the fuck's gonna happen next. And I don't even know how. I wonder how this man even got this fucking, like, this whole fucking song. But hey, man, let me know in the comments. You think this shit was harder than anything on both albums, or you think there was a track that was harder than this shit? Real stay shit. And we gonna play it out with the goddamn fucking league. Peace.
Let's listen in America today.
Life for the party. Yeah, almost time. It's the life for the party. To think I could've almost died. Go help us.
Hey, Miss Donda. You run and tell my mama, please tell her I said say something. I'm starting to believe ain't no such thing as heaven's trumpets. No after over, this is it done. If there's a heaven, you would think they let you speak to your son. Maybe she has in the form of a baby's laugh I heard passing by in a stroller, reminding me, hey, keep rolling, oh no. Maybe she has with the prick of a blade of grass I've been laying on way too long, got me itchy, got up and roamed a little more. Miss Donda, you see my mama, tell her I'm lost. You see, she'd always light a cigarette, we talk, I would cough, exaggerating a little bit, so she get the point, trying to get her to stop smoking. I would lead and fire up a joint till I quit, started back up again. 20 years later, all that time, y'all thought a nigga was high, thought I was crazy. My mama, she ain't cut no corners, got me back on track. I don't miss her overstepping, but do miss her showing seven civilian life shit. Miss Donda, see my mama, whisper her this. The real reason I was geek to go to church, must confess. When y'all grown-ups would be in Bible study, that girl helping me with my homework, her and I were fucking so pure and perverted, so spirit spinning and dirty, so on, so on and so on. We hope that no one heard it. And to this day, I think her mama knew, but let us explore. Miss Donda, you see my father, please ask him why. He never married, always smiled, but was he happy inside? Because I carry my mother's name, did he carry shame with him? I'm sure she did it out of spite, was her decision at birth. Shit, she probably would hurt. Ah, poor baby, two young people with different views, a lot for a young lady. No coincidence, they both passed away from heart conditions. There's a dissidence at play, dad and mom do hard division. 3,000 poster child for big dick niggas raised by their mothers. I'm supposed to smile as if God knew that I would be trouble. Keeps me around for what I don't know, but I do know that it's crucial that we do so pronto. I don't know how much long though.
Mama, your son in the red hat had suffered setbacks, had shouldn't have said that's had made everyone mad. He made 808, so he's everyone dad. No, he ever gets that hope. Tyrone's by the shore, close my eyes, I can see more. No. Nobody punking me, nobody pressuring me, nobody gangsta me, especially when the gangsters eat thanks to me. And my favorite principal name was Mrs. Wooten. She was strict, the perfect instructor for young Putin. Vladimir, just so that is clear, whom should we fear when we know dad is here?
Daddy right here, daddy's right here.
I don't play, boy, over your dead body for my daughter posing playboy. We don't condone over-sexualization of the kids in the home. Battery in my back, this house of pain won't ever last. Sahad told me to my face,
That sicko mode was his biggest song. We're gone, cause Donda was the best ghostwriter I ever had. South Park had jokes about fist sticks. To this day, the whole team could kiss this dick. I put Virgil and Drake on the same text, and it wasn't about the matching Arc'teryx or Kid Cudi dress. Just told these grown men, stop it with the funny shit. I might hire the whole team from ACG. So don't text me like I'm Juanita JCV. Or more important, Monica Corgan, who was there for me. Somebody really there for me was rare for me. That was new air to breathe. When I was underappreciated, undervaluated, stockholders told me boardrooms would bore you. Can't remember going by your rules. Try to follow the Lord's rules. Jawi was the new Abu Dhabi. Told Drake don't play with me on GD. And he sent that message to everybody. So if I hit you with a WYD, you better hit me with, yes, sir, I'm writing everything you need. I told you I was gonna take the summer back. So any other cap won't take none of that. Wear my motherfucking red hat. Security and the nannies be forever handling. I can't stand it when it's talks of putting the kids back in Sierra Canyon when daddy got his own school. Trash mouth for these white people if you want. Why we build a team to get Hoover out the joint? I do what I want, bro, in my life. Serve and protect, long as it's my wife. Screaming on M and Yens for trying to lower the percentage of scams. See, I was going in back when they thought I was only making M's. Now it's 9 Billy. You ain't gotta like me, but you feel me. Do y'all feel me? Really? Get off scot-free, I'm talking really. Get off my knees, that's if you're with me. Get off your knees, that's if you're with me. Get off your knees and let's get free. Get off your knees and let's get free. Really, I mean really. Really, I mean really. I need release, I don't need police. I'm like nigga police. Y'all can't need me, never need me. For the real me, for the real me. I'm in win.
Put us all the way down, okay?
How was it?
We done.
You did a good job.
It was scary.
Good.